Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. On the occasion of Women Day today, I want to warmly welcome all of you to the Mukti's Each for All and All Women Conclave. Can we have a loud round of applause today? Without further ado, I want to introduce Ms. Anusha Srinivasan Iyer, a woman who has so many accolades to her credit that any introduction will fall short. So can we have a AV to just have a brief overview of her accomplishments?
Anusha Srinivasan Iyer is a writer, director, media strategist, a sought-after TEDx speaker, life coach, social entrepreneur, gender, animal and environment activist. She is also one of the driving forces behind the Make Earth Green Again Mega Foundation and Positive Farm Sanctuary, best known as a firebrand journalist with a golden heart. Anusha is also a newsmaker. As a global award-winning writer-director, her film on child labor and hope and happiness, Sare Sapne Apne Hai, has won rave reviews globally, besides over 70 awards, and has been screened in over 120 film festivals. Respected for her commitment to social, environmental, and cultural causes, she is the winner of the Life's Real Heroes Award of India 2019 and the Economic Times Icon Award for Strategic Brandmaker and Social Entrepreneurship. She has also been acknowledged as the ET Rising Indian by the Economic Times, christened the Queen Bee of Brand Strategy by Forbes India. Anusha is also the recipient of the National Excellence Award, Women of Influence Award, People's Excellence Award, Inspire Award, Dada Saheb Phalke Film Foundation Award, Main Hoon Beti Award, Samaj Ratna Award, Iconic Achievers Award, Haryana Garima Award, Perfect Women Achievers Award, Karmic Award, Egalitarian Earth Warrior Award at the National Summit of Holistic Sciences, and has been felicitated by Myers MIT Pune for her social consciousness, and has been acknowledged with the National Wellness Award by the Sri Swami Samarth Annakshetra Trust Akkalkot. Anusha believes that giving is living, and that each of us is a catalyst to make the earth greener and peaceful for a better tomorrow. More power to Anusha Srinivasan Iyer.
Smita Thai, for giving me this opportunity to be here. It feels really nice to stand in front of such accomplished people. The most important thing I want to ask you all today is, March 8th is Women's Day. What is November 19th? That's Men's Day. Why don't we know about it? Why don't we know about Men's Day? We don't know about Men's Day because all the 364 days seem to be belonging to the men. I think today the first pledge we must take is all the 365 days should be Women's Day. You know, when we were little children, we never fell short of milk. We never fell short of anything that we wanted to eat or drink. Why is it that we never fell short of any household material? You don't have a materials management division there. We don't have an HR. But our servants seem to replace themselves. Bhai nahi aayi, dusri bhai aa jati hai. But why is it that our father always comes home on time? Because the mother doesn't eat before the father comes home.
The mother is the best management person that you can ever learn. How to manage when the tact, how to see that everything is in place at the same time, and how to see that errant children have their equilibrium back in place. I'm sure that none of the management books can ever be the emotional attack that a mother can do. I'm sure that my mother will understand that, my children will understand. I think we should look at the women in our lives and feel inspired by them and make sure that every day that we give is Women's Day.
Every day we must look towards equality. Somewhere along the way, we don't have to be people who carry a beacon and run around town or scream or make noise or be activists. But if you see something wrong happening somewhere, I think we all have the right to stand up and say what is right. Because for a person who is doing wrong, is wrong. We all know that. But the one who's taking it, like how women take domestic abuse, they take emotional abuse, they take physical abuse, and they still stand by that man all through and through, and sometimes in front of a cop also they say, no, it's okay, it's routine. What is routine? And what is regular? And what is family? These are words that I don't understand. Wrong is wrong, right is right. As simple as that. And when it comes to beating up somebody, when it comes to emotionally abusing somebody, when it comes to hurting somebody, there can never be a right or routine. Each of us should just take a pledge today that the rest of the 364 days also belongs to all the women. Not just all the women everywhere, but all the women who we are. Today, next year, I'm going to be 50. But you see, I still think I'm 16. It's my attitude towards life. For the simple reason that I love myself. It was not like every day of these 49 years I loved myself. We all go through ups and downs. We all go through those times when we get a knockout, sucker punch, and we decide, bas, khatam ho gayi zindagi. But when you stand up for yourself, when you realize you love yourself, there is no one greater in this world that you must love than your own self. Today you're feeling low, come on, yaar, let's go shopping. Kuch nahi to online hi le lenge. Budget nahi hai to China mein shop kar lenge. But end of the day, you need to reward yourself. You need to feel happy. You need to feel proud. You need to feel good. You need to dress up. Who cares if the rest of the world is watching or not? I go to Kokila Ben, what, I still wear the same dress. It is us. It is we who need to love ourselves. And we must take this pledge that on this day we decide the rest of the year belongs to us as much. Not just the year, the days, but every moment is ours. And let us relish it to the best and let us just do a little thing and let us pass this same empowerment on to the next woman that we meet. And let us teach her to learn to live with respect, dignity, happiness. And let us stop all the wrong that happens, because every time a lamp in a woman lights itself, we light the entire world. Smita Thai is one powerful example, as are each of these people in this room and each of these dignitaries who would come up on stage, because each of them first lit themselves and then brought light into this world. I take this opportunity to be thankful to Smita Ji for what she's done for us, and I would like her AV to be played so we can take this forward from here.